Welcome to the show. What do Classic Game Room and RoboCop have in common? We both love TJ Laser. Also, we're both going to be on Blu-ray soon. RoboCop already is on Blu-ray, but Classic Game Room will be because the Best of Classic Game Room DVD on Kickstarter has been doing so well that we have surpassed the Blu-ray tier. So, soon you'll be able to enjoy. The year is 2102. The universe is in danger.
Mark! This is Future Mark. I'm coming to you from the future. I see you've received my laser disc. I need your help.
It's a journey beyond reality as two Marks team up to save the galaxy from...
What? Put your hand down. What is it?
Does Future Mark always wear a headband?
Edit Station 1.
He's not right next to you, is he?
It's not an ATST, it's not a Tauntaun. That's right, kids. It's Ed 209.
They push this little button back here on Ed 209 and he makes all kinds of fun sound effects.
So what do you get with the Best of Classic Game Room 15th Anniversary Collection? Well, you get more than 4 hours of Classic Game Room goodness, behind the scenes footage, and big reviews like the AT-AT, Truxton, and Cosmic Carnage, as well as Super Metroid, Shenmue, and Half-Life. Complete with feature-length commentary from this guy, one of the Mark clones. Let's watch some more footage. Welcome to the Classic Game Room road test. Ferrari 575 Maranello versus 1972 Chevy El Camino. Which is better? Yes, the Ferrari has a beautiful interior made from exquisite materials, but where am I supposed to play my KC and the Sunshine Band 8-track collection?
A beautiful day in outer space. This is simulated, of course. It feels real, though.
Oh, all right, and I don't even think these are both going to fit in here. No, they definitely cannot comfortably fit in there and still leave room for a sword.
The reviews have changed a lot since then, perhaps because I've played so much Truxton, one of the greatest games ever created. You can't talk about Classic Game Room without talking about the amazing Truxton for Sega Genesis, the game that literally made Future Mark crazy. I'm concerned about him.
I don't know where I'm supposed to put this. It's just... Let's try the El Camino and see how that works.
No need to lift any trunk. And they easily fit inside the 72 El Camino with room to spare.
Credit where credit's due, the Ferrari does drive nicely. It also looks cool, but it does not haul alligators. Unless you chop them up into little bits, and even then not very many of them.
Not only is there room for the Atari 5200 and Xbox, but plenty of room for a Mark and the sword. Get that dragonfly out of the shot. Move!
The only thing worse than the GameCom is playing games on the GameCom. This is the horrible Sonic Jam for the GameCom. Follow the link in the description, check out the Kickstarter page, and once again, thank you to everyone who's backing this project, who's contemplating backing this project, and all of you who backed the Lord Carnage comic book. So I'll see you soon on Classic Game Room with reviews like Soul Feast, and of course the Zap.
It's remarkably easy to break 100 miles per hour in a 25 while driving the Ferrari. Not that I just did that.
Here's some behind-the-scenes actions, what really goes on at Classic Game Room. It appears that Fuzzix on Twitter has sent me a picture of beer in the Classic Game Room drinking glass, and his avatar is the punk rocker from Star Trek IV. So, there's only one thing to do in this situation. Fuzzix, cheers. Have a good weekend. It's a beautiful thing. Outer space never tasted so good.
I can direct insects.